Hey everyone, you might have noticed that Mystic, the AI app for print on demand, made a few changes a little while ago and I haven't made a video for it. So in this video, I'm going to talk about some of the changes. Most notably is the categories and subcategories that they added. And they added a little thing for the remix feature. So I'm going to talk about that as well. So I'm going to share my favorite categories within the subcategories that they have on their webpage. I'm going to show you all about it and how that new remix feature works in the end. So stay tuned for that. So let's get into Mystic POD right now and I'll show you all the changes. All right, so here I am on Mystic, mysticpod.com, and I'm on the templates. By default, the templates are on the homepage. You got designs and collections. I'm not going to go into that. Those things stayed the same. The things that I noticed that changed right here are all these different categories. So before they had the categories, but now they have so many more that they're in groups. So categories, styles, and the subcategories here. Interests, look at all the interests. Holidays, animals, food, season, school, and other. So I'm gonna go in this video, I'm gonna share my favorite one in each one of these. So I think there's 8 of them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So not necessarily the top 8 categories, but my favorite within these categories that I think you should take a look at, especially for Q4, because I think a lot of these can help you in Q4. In fact, what they put on their homepage is Halloween costumes, because that's coming up. You can see that we can put these on t-shirts and be these different things. The pirate, that looks great there. And then we got more things besides costumes. They got a lot of costumes, but a lot of fall stuff coming up too here. So really cool. So I'm going to share some of those things that are relative to what you should be looking at and selling for POD this year. And then, of course, I'm going to show you a remix thing that you may not have known about. They kind of like slipped this one in as well. So first, let's take a look at styles. We have boho, abstract, anime, goth. A lot of these they had before. The one that I like is kawaii. Of course, I'm going to pick kawaii. But they did a really good job at kawaii stuff. And there's a lot of them. So look at these pumpkins for fall. This is one good way to stand out from the rest, because I don't think a lot of people actually do kawaii stuff. And sometimes this sells and sometimes it doesn't. Not like a guarantee, but definitely a way to stand out if you're going to do something in like a cute ghost or a cute bats and stuff like that. Is a cool, and black cats, of course. Kawaii cats do it really well, but they love the food and stuff. And of course, you don't have to, this is where you start with these templates. If you see something like this cat right here, you would remix it and change the words, change the style cat, and so on. And they even have other stuff, but food and animals are usually the biggest things in kawaii. But look, I'm scrolling in it and it keeps going. 4th of July stuff and anime and so on. So really big, really exciting that they have that many kawaii stuff in here. So that's why I picked that. It's because it's usually underserved. And right now there's lots of really nice ones, especially for the fall and Christmas and things coming up. All right. And the new way to get rid of this, you can see kawaii replace the drop down. You can still come in here and look at the other ones, or you could click this off and then it goes back to styles and goes back to the home page. So that's how that kind of works. Interest. So the one that I like here in the interest one is outdoors, because I think a lot of these outdoor designs are actually going to sell during the holidays, during this Q4 period, because we have a lot of outdoor stuff like this, outdoor costumes, but also animals and things like that, that just, the fall colors and things like that. And you can see they have a ton of outdoor stuff on here, kind of mixing some Halloween stuff in there, but the classic ones, things like that, and some, puns and things like that. So a lot of fall stuff here for the outdoors as well. Just some really nice stuff. This one's really cool. So take a look at this. I am still scrolling on here. So they got a ton of outdoor stuff. And again, you can come in here and remix this. Maybe you don't want a wolf. You want a different animal here. Maybe you don't want it to say campfire crew. You want something else. So you can start here and then use some of these ideas. This is a great one too. A lot of times they do the, I've seen this a lot, sell a lot of the trucks with the pumpkins in the back. That's a classic one. Animals in the forest and things like that is pretty cool. All right, so that's number two, outdoors. Again, you can click on here, pick one of these other ones if you want to see those, or just close it. Next thing, holidays. I'm going to pick Halloween, of course, because I think that's the next big holiday that you should be designing for. And of course, we got the costumes like we saw on the front page, but I think there's a lot more than just that. I mean, those are good, but there's a lot of ghost stuff here, black cats, some puns, jack-o'-lantern, just some cool art stuff for Halloween. So these can help you get some sales for Halloween. I don't think it's too late, but it's getting close because we're almost a month away on here. So a lot of cool things. I would get these done right now. If you want to design for Halloween, I would make sure to use some of these right now in your print on demand stuff. And you know, this is so cool. Look at this artwork here. I'm just gonna, wow, that's really nice. All right, I'm gonna go back and scroll up and go to the next one. The next one for animals, my favorite is raccoon. So you saw how many animals there are here. Some of these aren't actually raccoons, but anyway, they're cool. I guess some cats look like raccoons. There's a raccoon there and so on. Raccoons are really big this year for whatever reason, especially like these vintage ones. And then you can take kind of this idea and it already has the style and then change it to words that it could relate to, you know, maybe the fall or Halloween or Thanksgiving or whatever. I think these can be really cool. I like this style of them right here. Kind of almost kawaii, vintage kawaii. Look at the artwork on these. Really cool. This is a funny one too. You can just add some words to that. So that'd be, oh, I just missed this one. Look at the raccoon moon. That's amazing. Oh, this is a really cool idea for Dia de los Muertos. Raccoon Dia de los Muertos. Wow, that's pretty cool. All right. Anyway, raccoon. And you can see all the other animals. Cats and dogs do really, really well during Q4 because people love their pets and so on. So good list of animals there. For food, I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna pick coffee because I think coffee would definitely sell. There's lots of people who love coffee. Coffee designs do really well in Q4. So take a look at these, especially this. People love reading books and pumpkins. Like this is perfect for that. There's some other things with coffee here. A lot of different styles too. So you got like this minimalist style, you got the almost watercolor looking style, text style, and so on. So some really cool ones for coffee here. And it just keeps going. So a lot of nice stuff in here for coffee. All right, take a look at that. Next one for seasons. Of course, I'm gonna pick fall since that's the next season coming up here. We're probably in fall already. I think summer's pretty much done. So look at that. Oh, that's a cool one. So just combining different fall ones. That's a really neat one. Sometimes you don't need words. Sometimes this is all you need. This is fun with the coffee and everything. So take a look at some of these fall ideas, sweater weather and so on. So yeah, have fun with this one. This is a great list of fall designs that can get you inspired to create something on your own. And sometimes, again, doesn't need words. Sometimes this is enough to put on a t-shirt that people like. All right, getting close to here. School is a category. I'm gonna just pick teachers because a lot of times teachers if you know somebody that's a teacher, you can get a gift for them, give it to them during Q4. And yeah, so this is good. Of course, we got the Halloween teachers on here, science teachers and so on. But you also got some other ones for teachers here. This could be a teacher. It says lunch lady, but it could be a teacher, back to school. Some of these are a lot of back to school stuff. But yeah, I think some of these could be definitely for teachers. And teachers of specific grades, like kindergarten or first grade, second grade, that's kind of thing, case for kindergarten and so on. So if you have a second grade teacher, right, that could be a cool gift right there. And lastly, for other, there's so many good other ones, but the one that I want to say is family, because these make really good gifts for moms and dads and other people in the family. These sell really well in Q4. They don't have to be about the fall. They don't have to be about Christmas. They can just be, you know, for people who, like, if you have a dad that's a golden, that owns a golden retriever, perfect. If you have a mom that's a dog, owns a dog, there you go. If you have a mom that has a kid in the marching band and so on. So look at these. This is really cool for moms and dads and uncles and aunts. And like, again, these are, you can scale these, right? Like, instead of uncle, you can have this do a whole bunch of different ones. In fact, that's what we're gonna do now. So I'm gonna show you the secret, not so secret remix thing that they added. Okay, so let's say you wanna do this golden retriever dad, but you know that there's a lot more dog breeds out there. So I'm gonna hit remix and check this out. This is the kind of the new thing that they added here. It's using AI to suggest to you something that it could do. Now, if you can't think of like, how am I gonna remix this to make it better or different? You don't need to even worry about it. They have it right here. Let me talk about some of these other things before I hit the remix. So there's style, of course. Here's all the different styles they had before. There's niche. So let's say you want to change this dog dad into maybe a fitness thing or some custom niche that you want, you can do that. So if you like the idea or the style of one of these, but you're actually in a different niche that you're designing for, you're in the fitness niche, you want to change this, you like this style, this vintage style, but want to do that, you can click that. You can click up to 5 different generations of this, and then you can do what product. I think by default, since we're in t-shirts, it's going to do the t-shirt product. Size, since it was a square, it's the default is the square. And model is just going to use the latest model, but you can choose those things. All right, so let's try this out. This one says proud golden retriever dad, although that's really close to what that says. Retro dog dad vibes, that's different. Furry friend forever. Wow, that's pretty cool. So let's just do that. I like the alliteration there. I'm just gonna do that, and you can see it writes its own prompt for you. So that's pretty cool. And then I'm gonna just hit remix, and I did it 5 times, so it's gonna use 5 credits. And then it's gonna put it in my designs file right here. And we should see what it looks like. I'm also gonna do one to scale this. So I'm gonna do this again, remix. I'm gonna do 5. Now I hope this works. I said change the words golden retriever to different dog types and change the graphic to match. So crossing my finger that this works. I'm gonna hit remix as well for that one. I believe the other one is already done. So let's take a look here. Yeah. So furry friend forever, it changed the dog here. It's not done, but you can see it did change. So I could use any one of these. I'm gonna click on one here and take a look. Yeah, this is good. So it changed the words for me. It has a dog here and it says furry friend forever dad instead of the golden retriever one that we had. That's pretty cool. Now I can go back, I believe, and it goes back to the original and forward here. And then I could upscale this 4 times, so it's actually the good size for it, and download it. Let's see, and we got style here. I could change the style from here. If I wanted to remix this again, I can change the style here. If I wanted to do it again in a different size, I can do it there, and then also remix this one again. And then let's see what we got here. it did do it. I should have said keep the same style, but let's take a look at some of these. Shiba Inu dad, that's really cool. And it just put that in there. So you can see how I can scale this. really quickly. It did five for me, but I can do even more. So there you go. I like all of these different ones, but that's kind of a game changer. It works on every single one. So if I go back here and let's pick another one. I'm gonna go down to family again. I like that one. Let's do something that's not like a dog one. Let's see what it comes up with. Pizza dad three, oops, sorry. So you don't see it in here. When you come in here and try and remix it, you won't see it in there. You will only see it if you do remix and then here. So let's see. Papa's pizza triad. Oh, that's kind of cool. Slices of datitude. That's really neat. Three times the cheese. So if you can't think of, you know, a phrase to put in here to remix it and you want to keep it different, it has it here for you, which is pretty cool. So it's kind of like that idea of, you know, finding the phrase for me or asking ChatGPT what phrases. It just does it. And the nice thing is when you click on it, it writes the right prompt for you. So you don't have to like write the prompt. And if this prompt, after reading this prompt, thinking that, oh, maybe I want to change something in here, you can do that. This is editable. You can see that. But I usually leave it because I'm lazy and I think it writes the right one. So I'm going to hit this. Again, I like doing five just because sometimes it just gives you different ideas. So I like doing that. And so I'll hit remix here and let's see what happens. This is so cool. Again, you can scale these like beer me, I'm promoted to grandpa or grandma or uncle or, you know, all those things. This too, husband, dad, fantasy football legend, you could change the words and scale that and so on. So this is really cool that it has that. Or if, you know, there's some other ones that you may not know how to change the words up, but maybe you like the graphic, it can do that for you. So let's take a look at what it came up with. So there you go. It had slices of datitude, all of them, but all of them are different too. So this one says the cheesiest dad, a slice above, all good vibes, fresh and fun, dad, life supreme. So I like that when you do the five, it gives you five different ideas. So you don't have to think of those. So there you go. I kind of like a slice above. That's kind of cool. I like that pun. And really cool design. Look at that. Slices of datitude. That's funny. All right, so those are the new features in Mystic. I think it's great. I think there's a lot to see here. I would suggest go through all of these and see what style and topic that you like and find one. It's really easy. Like I said, you can remix it, and it does. What I really like about it is that it upscales it four times, so it's definitely the right size for print on demand once you got it at that four times size. All right, so there you go. Those are the latest updates that I've seen on Mystic POD. Let me know what you think, which category was your favorite, and what do you think about that new thing for remix, the suggestions? Let me know about that in the comments. Now, I haven't made a Mystic video for a while, but the last one I did was this one where I compared it to Playground and Ideogram. So if you haven't seen that one yet, take a look there. It kind of compares all the different features that each of them have. It's pretty cool. Thanks again for watching, and as always, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.